Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass workshop series where we build a ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrate with wired, wireless, Active Directory and much more. In our previous video, we did some moving around of services in the service rules for ClearPass to make sure that we get the guest captive portal pop up automatically. So we are now at the self-registration page and we were halfway configuring, so let's see where we are. Type in my name, email address, and accept the terms and conditions and register for an account. And you can see we have an account registered here with the email address as the username and a randomly generated password. We can show the password here on screen. Of course, there are also different workflows where we are sending the password instead over a SMS text message or through an email, so we know that someone has access to a phone number or to an email address. As well, we can do a sponsored login where someone in the organization has to approve the account. When we press login, we see that we are looping back, and that's because we are not finished yet with the configuration. So in order to get the authentication done correctly without any certificate warnings, we need to have a certificate installed on the instant AP. This certificate needs to be a normal HTTPS SSL certificate, so the same that you would request for a web server, for example. And it can be the cheapest there is, as long as it's supported and if it's recognized by most of your clients. And I have a certificate prepared already with the name captiveportal-login.airheads.eu, and we need to install that on the instant AP. Let's have a look how we can do that. Let's now install the certificate. So we go to the maintenance certificates and there we can upload a new certificate. Let me get the file for the certificate. So it's this PEM file, which has the certificate and the intermediate and the private key. We'll give it a label to be uploaded to the instant AP. Let's call it captive portal. And the type will be server. It's a server certificate. And the passphrase that we need to get decrypted the key, and we can upload a certificate. Now you can see that we have it there. So captiveportal-login.airheads.eu. And now we need to assign the certificate usage. So we select the captive portal server application, server certificate, and we select our uploaded captive portal. And now we see that we don't see it, and that's because the captive portal certificate, once there is a new certificate, it's also uploaded as the web UI certificate, so we need to reconnect. And as you can see, the configuration was saved, so now we have the captive portal server certificate. So what's also good now is to check on the instant AP, because the instant AP, when a client will request the name for that captive portal, so you can see before it was securelogin.arubanetwork.com. If we do the same command, show captive portal domains, we now see that we have the captive portal login.airheads.eu, so the new certificate that we uploaded. And the AP will automatically respond if the client will do a DNS request for this name with its own IP address. And if we check in the guest registration page, that's also the name that should be there. So if we go into the NAS vendor settings, you can see there we have the captive portal login.airheads.eu, and it's the same that's in the instant AP. So the AP should now respond to that name. Good, let's get back to our client and now try to log in again. We see it now takes longer, but we still are returned to the original page. So now it's time to have a look in our access tracker again, and we can see that we have a reject on the service, and it is because the service is matching not on the captive portal one, but on the Aruba Instant Wireless. So we'll need to make another change in the service matching rules. So we see the Aruba Instant Wireless is above the guest user authentication. And if we check in the wireless.1x, we can see there is no checking on the SSID. And the easiest way to fix this is to do a check on the SSID. If we check radius Aruba, ESSID name contains corp. So any SSID that has the name corp in it, like our Airheads corp SSID, will be matching on this service. And if it's Airheads guest, then it will fall through and get to service 13, where we have a check on the Airheads guest SSID. Okay, let's try again. Register, login. Now we see the call to the captive portal login, and we see that we are connected, so that doesn't look too bad. Let's see how that will look in Access Tracker. So now we see an radius accept on the captive portal service. And if we check, we can see a lot of information. So we can see the MAC off expiry, the MAC caching is set, and we get the guest role. However, if we check on the instant AP, we can see that we still have the default role and not the guest role. And that is because we had these roles defined, so guest and guest CP, but we didn't create them yet on the instant AP. Now it's time to create them. So we go to configuration, security, to the roles, and there we can create new roles. So let's start with our guest role. So that's the role for guests that are authenticated. So we can allow everything to all destinations for that. You could, of course, block outgoing traffic to specific sites or to specific protocols, but let's keep it open for now. And let's create another one, a guest CP, which will do a captive portal redirect. So the role type will be captive portal. The splash page type will be an external. And there we can select the previously defined CPM guest registration. So this will do a redirect for all traffic to the captive portal. So that's it. So let's now try to bounce our client so we can delete it from the instant AP. And you can see the role immediately changed to guest. And also if we check our access tracker, we can see that we now have, based on the MAC caching, so this is the MAC authentication, not the captive portal authentication. And based on the MAC authentication, we can also see that we have the MAC caching role there. And now let's have a look on the client. We are still connected. Yeah, we are still connected. And that's because we have the guest role based on the MAC caching and as well the username. So that's why we see the username as well based on the MAC authentication request. Role is guest, username is my email address. That looks good. However, we are now authenticated based on the MAC caching. And what we now will do is remove everything. Let's make this like it is a new situation. So you can see here that we have the guest role ID and we have the MAC off expiration and the username, so that's all stored in the endpoint database. We can just now remove these attributes and then it would be like the device is new to the network and unknown to the ClearPass. If in the instant we disconnect the client again, it should be redirected to the captive portal. There we go. Now immediately let's have a look in the access tracker. So we see a reject. So with a reject, you get to the default role, which is a captive portal on our SSID. And now we return to the client and login. We see the login happening and we are authenticated. So there we go. So this is the web captive portal authentication. If we now disconnect the client, it should re-authenticate based on the MAC caching. So there we go. There's the MAC caching entry and we get access. And now to show the MAC caching, what we can do is we can go into the endpoint and we can manually now change the MAC off expiry. So if we change it to yesterday instead of tomorrow, then we should have an expired MAC authentication, just for simulating that situation. So normally this will go all automatically. If we now disconnect our client and check again in Access Tracker, we should see an accept. However, we see the username now as the MAC address and we are returning the guest CP role, which does the redirect on the client. So if we go to anywhere, we can see that we are redirected again. And what we see is that we have the guest CP role there, which does the redirect to the ClearPass server. If we check in the captive portal service, we can see in the response that we have the MAC off expiry pushed into the endpoint, the username being pushed in the endpoint. Also there we can see the stuff for the bandwidth check. And if we scroll down, we can also see the active session count. So that's being matched against the number of maximum clients that we have in our policy. In this video, we finalized our basic guest self-registration workflow from the automatic captive portal pop-up to the registration to the Mac caching scenarios. We did a removal of the Mac auth expiry and we saw that we got a reject and got in the captive portal. And we artificially expired our Mac auth expiry and saw that at that point we got a raw guest CP where we are redirected to the captive portal. And basically, that's it for the guest scenario on wireless. Really hope this was useful. If so, please press the like button. If you have questions, put them under the video in the comments section. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks a lot for watching.